by our standards.
You're cozy in your house, and you go outside, and you realize, wow, it's cold.
Okay, now okay? I understand what you're trying to say.
Because you're sitting in your house, you think everything's fine, but then you step outside. What happens? What's the world? This is San Diego. It's not supposed to be 45.
Like now, definitely, it's not supposed to be that cold. We're dealing with definitely below average temperatures, and even for the East Coast, I'm sorry, but yeah, this is definitely a polar air mass that's actually just sank into San Diego County. So, Mike, our engineer Mike sent this in, Mike Black, El Cajon, and look at that. That is frost, definitely on the car, on the windows. There's a couple other cars, I'm blocking it with the banner, but there's another car right behind, and it is covered also with frost. So definitely those ice crystals in place because the temperatures have dropped overnight into this morning between 25 and 35 miles, 35 degrees rather. And the frost advisory is for the valleys until 9 o'clock. So a little bit over an hour still with this frost advisory, but really the whole county is dealing with freezing or sub-freezing temperatures. So just to give you an idea, look at this. This is the current temperatures in Ramona, 25 degrees. Alpine, 35. Descanso, below freezing with 29. Julian, only 25 degrees. Fallbrook, 36. Escondido, 34. Even in the North County, we're dealing with 37 in Carlsbad, 39 in Oceanside, La Mesa, 39. And temperatures trending 7 to 21 degrees, colder than yesterday at this time. So just to give you an overall broad view of what's happening, the West Coast, much colder temperatures, even in California, up and down the state. The East Coast, current temperatures, even in Chicago, 61 degrees. So right now, Ramona, 25, it is colder than Chicago. It is colder than Cleveland. It is colder than Washington, D.C., Nashville, colder than New Orleans, of course, Dallas, colder than Dallas for sure. So there's a ridge of high pressure in the east, and they're getting temperatures that are extremely warm, even record-breaking temperatures, and of course, also some thunderstorms, severe weather. For us, we're going to remain with temperatures very cold, 5 to 15 degrees below the normal, 59 for the coastal areas, 58 for the inland valleys, and then it's going to become a little unsettled by Wednesday. We're going to have a little trough of low pressure Wednesday. It's going to be weak. The second one will be on Thursday, and the third one will be on Sunday into Monday. So the one for Thursday seems to be a little bit stronger. Not expecting a whole lot of rain because they don't have a lot of moisture. They're taking an inside track. So by Wednesday, we may see a little bit of light rain or drizzle. The best chance will be Wednesday night into Thursday. We may even get some snow because the second storm system, the one on Thursday and Friday, will be very cold. So we're going to get a chance of some snow over our local mountains into Friday morning. So definitely not only the cold, but even snow and even a chance of some light precipitation coming our way, and every little bit counts. Here's a look at your 7-day forecast powered by AccuWeather. Temperatures will remain below average for the rest of the week. We'll warm up slightly by the weekend. Inland area 61, colder temperatures Wednesday and Thursday, and even lower by Friday with 55 degrees. Overnight lows are going to plummet in the 30s and even upper 20s. Let's take a look at traffic before I get out the door.